الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله الله الحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير السنن سنن محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد فقال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتاب الله العظيم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لو انزلنا هذا القران على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله وتلك الامثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Ramadan is fast approaching and lot of us are supplicating in this month, Allahumma ballighna Ramadan. We are invoking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us an opportunity to witness the month of Ramadan and to give us an opportunity to reform ourselves and to take maximum advantage of the coming month. One of the things we can do is to rejuvenate and strengthen our relationship with Quran. And that is going to be my topic of khutbah today. Probably I spoke to you long back in the same subject, but due to the relevance of Ramadan, I am going to speak about the same subject, our responsibilities towards Quran. I am going to speak to you the simple 5 responsibilities which all of us can remember and which all of us can try to strengthen these kind of relationship in the month of Ramadan. The first responsibility is to believe and respect Quran. And the second responsibility is to read Quran. And the third responsibility is to understand Quran. And fourth responsibility is to follow Quran. And the fifth responsibility is to convey the message of Quran. It is the 5 responsibilities very easy and very simple to understand. And month of Ramadan, which is month of Quran, Quran says that شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. Ramadan is the month when Quran is revealed to human being. هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. And it is a guidance to the entire human being. And it is a criterion to distinguish between truth and falsehood. And this month is coming, and this is a very ideal month for us to rebuild our relationship with Quran. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in his beautiful hadith, he says, Al-Qalilu Da'imu Khairum Min Kathirul Munqata. It is a very beautiful hadith, very beautiful piece of advice. If you follow this advice in every aspect of life, you will be very successful. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Qalilu Da'imu Khairum Min Kathirul Munqata. If you do something little but regularly, is much better than you do very much, a lot, but with big intervals. That is what we do normally with Quran. We read a lot Quran in the month of Ramadan. We try to complete the entire 30 juz of Quran. And again, we try to understand Quran. We try to read the meaning of the Quran. We attend all Taraweeh prayers so that we can hear Quran melodiously from various beautiful reciters in Quran and in your surrounding areas. But after the month of Ramadan, where is our relationship with Quran? After the month of Ramadan, we fold the book of Quran and keep it in the highest place in our almirahs and in our cupboards, just as a mark of respect that it has to be kept in a highest place. Otherwise, we do not have a regular contact with Quran in our daily life. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that al-qalilu da'imu khayrun min kathirul munqata. We should have anything you do very little but very regularly is much better than you do a lot but with big intervals. So that is what we do. The same thing we apply to Quran, that we read a lot in Quran in the month of Ramadan. But as soon as the Ramadan, month of Ramadan is fast, our relationship is gone with Quran. That should not be the case. Let us make a pledge that this month of Ramadan will start a new kind of rejuvenate our relationship with Quran, and we will strengthen and we will continuously develop a relationship with Quran. Let us come to the first responsibility, that we should respect and believe in Quran. All of us believe that Quran is book of God. All of us respect it. We have a great respect towards Quran. But what are the requisites of respect? Respect means just keeping it in a highest place, or touching it to our eyes, or keeping it very near to our heart. That's not only the requisites of respect. It has many other responsibilities. When we fulfill the other following responsibilities, which I am going to mention in my khutbah, we really testify that we believe and we respect Quran. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam was so much affiliated to Quran that every day he used to read Quran. And his companions, they were so attached to Quran that they used to complete Quran every 7 days. They used to read it. During the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Quran was divided into 7 hizb. Now later on it is developed, it is printed. Now we have a printed form of Quran, and there are 30 parts in Quran. Well, this is all the later development for made easy for you to understand Quran and to read Quran. During the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they used to read Quran as 7 hizbs. 7 days, in a 7 days they used to, if you devote around 2 to 2.5 hours for Quran, you will be able to complete it. But because of the busy life, so many of you may not get time. At least minimize it and should develop a Quran, a regular contact with Quran. If you see your life, divide 24 hours of your life and see, analyze what you are doing in 24 hours. Some people are very productive in 24 hours. Some people are less productive in 24 hours. No one in the world has more than 24 hours. Most productive people in this world also have 24 hours a day, not more than that. How they are more productive, how they utilize it more? Because of the perfect time management. And Islam is all about time management. 5 times prayer every day. It teaches you how to manage your time. It teaches you how to be disciplined. It strengthens your concentration. You can be more productive if you are following all injunctions of Islam. So in your 24 hours a day, analyze that what we are doing. Almost 8 to 10 hours we are sleeping. 1 to 2 hours we are eating. 2 to 3 hours we are sitting in front of TV. 8 hours, maybe 7 hours we are working and gossiping and all other things and staying with family. Where is the time for Quran? Do you have 10 minutes, 15 minutes regularly for Quran? If you do not have regular timing for Quran, you are not really respecting Quran in the way which is needed. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he was so concerned about Quran that he used to read himself and he used to listen from others every day about Quran. And whoever are the good reciters, like Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala, he was a very good reciter, and it was a practice of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam to listen Quran from Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala. And something, if you have attachment, definitely you have a kind of relationship with that. For example, if you are anticipating an email or a letter from somebody you love, you have all kind of curiosity to open that email or open that letter and read it and to understand the message in it. Because of your love towards the person from where email is coming, or because of your relationship with the person the person who is sending the letter. In the same way, if you have real taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, attachment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are very eager and attached to the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we are eager to learn the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is necessary, that you should have a great attachment, and you should have a regular time, and you should have a devoted time to learn and to build relationship and to understand Quran. And moreover, you have to understand the responsibility which Quran gives to you. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says, لَوْ أَنزَلْنَا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ عَلَى جَبَلٍ لَرَأَيْتَهُ خَاشِئًا مُتَصَدِّعًا مِّنْ خَشِيَةِ اللَّهِ. If we would have revealed this Quran upon a mountain, you would have seen that it is turning into pieces, breaking into pieces with the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala mentions this particular ayah here just to make you understand that how serious is the message of Quran. If power of perception is given to a gigantic structure like mountain, it would have been broken into pieces with the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But human beings, they are carriers of the Quran, they have Quran with them, they read Quran, but they are least influenced by Quran. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says about the believers that إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. Real believers are the one, when Allah is mentioned to them, they feel an enhancement in their belief. And when the recitation of Quran is done in front of them, when Quran is recited in front of them, their heart will tremble. They experience a fear in their heart about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, about the sense of responsibility. And we can know that we listen to Quran, we sometimes enjoy the recitation like any other songs. But do you really sense the responsibilities you have towards Quran? If you are not sensing this responsibility that we are the last carriers of Quran, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is, Quran is revealed to the last messenger, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No more messenger is going to come after that. But the message, conveying the message of Quran, is given to Muslims. So this is the serious kind of responsibility which Muslims have to fulfill in their life. And this kind of responsibility, we always remember when you hear Quran, when you listen to Quran. So this kind of responsibility and this kind of sense of responsibility should be there when we recite Quran or when we listen to Quran. If you are not feeling this kind of a sense of responsibility, that means you are not fulfilling the requisites of belief and the requisites of respect towards Quran. So this is the first and foremost responsibility, that we have to strengthen our belief with Quran, and we have to strengthen our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that we have a great attachment, an everyday attachment with Quran, and we always feel the sense of responsibility towards Quran. The second responsibility is to read Quran. And reading, it should become a regular practice in our life. We read, of course, in 5 times prayer. And apart from 5 times prayer, there should be a devoted time in your life that you have to read Quran. And you have to devote a time, and it should be, even if it is a little time, that should be a devoted time for reading Quran. Imam Ghazali, Rahmatullah Alayh, he said that in his life, he has a practice of completing the entire Quran. He says that I have a practice that I complete entire Quran in 7 days. And I have another practice that in different way of reading, I complete Quran in 1 year. I have another different practice of reading Quran in which I will not complete reading Quran in 30 years. I have not completed it. And this means there are different kinds of reading. One is rendering without thinking. Another reading is reading with intervals. When you read it, think about it, ponder over it, and think deeply about it, comprehend about it. So different kinds of reading. So you have to adopt all these kinds of reading. And while reading, what is important is you have to follow the rules of phonetics, which is called tajweed. It is responsibility of every Muslims. And those who are living in Gulf countries, for them there are a lot of opportunity to learn tajweed. And also in internet, nowadays there are lot of sites where they teach tajweed, they teach understanding Quran, and this kind of stuff are available in your laptops, in your home. Just it's a click away to learn tajweed and to learn more knowledge about Quran and Islam. It is very click away, very easy for you. It's just a click away for you nowadays with the advancement of technology. So it is necessary that we have to read Quran with tajweed. And also it is a responsibility while reading. It is our responsibility that we should try to read it beautifully. Again, it is a responsibility. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَيْسَ مِنَّا مَنْ لَا يَتَغَنَّ بِالْقُرْآنِ وَزَيِّنُ الْقُرْآنَ بِأَصْوَاتِكُمْ. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that he is not amongst us who is not beautifying Quran while reading. And beautify Quran from your voice. And it is not possible that everybody is not blessed with beautiful voice and everybody is not well versed in this kind of art of reading it beautifully. But those who can read it, they should try to read it beautifully. But everybody can learn tajweed, and whoever can read it beautifully, it is necessary that they should learn to read Quran in a beautiful rhythmic way. And it is the only book which can be read in a rhythmic way. For example, so many other epics, so many other books, so-called religious books, cannot be read in a rhythmic way. Bible cannot be read in a rhythmic way. It is again a miracle of Quran that it can be read in a very rhythmic and beautiful way and in a soothing way, that when you read it, it is very attractive, and it will grab your attention. In the initial days when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was conveying the message of Islam, lot of people came to Islam only with the attraction, by impressing by the rhythmic voice of Quran. For example, Tufail bin Amr Dusi, when he was coming to Mecca, lot of idolaters, they prevented him from entering Mecca, saying that there is a prophet who is reading some recitations in such a beautiful way that whoever listens to it, they will be attracted, they will be impressed by it. That's why he put cotton in his ears and he entered Mecca. And after entering Kaaba, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was reciting Quran al-Kareem in Kaaba. And even after putting cotton in his ear, he was able to listen little bit of Quran. And it was very attractive. Then he removed his cotton, he attentively listened to it, then the whole world changed. And he said that definitely it cannot be a man-made scripture, it is definitely a message of God. Then he came to the fold of Islam. It can be read in an attractive way, so it is the responsibility of Muslims to try to read it in an attractive way. Another way of reading it is tarteel. There is a way of reading which is called tarteel. And especially during night, when you read Quran, you have to read it with tarteel, with intervals. When you read it, ponder over on each word you are reciting. وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا. Quran says that you read Quran with tarteel, with intervals. Especially when you wake up in the nights for tahajjud prayer and also for taraweeh prayer. We call it taraweeh prayer, actually it is qiyamul layl. Taraweeh means there are intervals. Tarweeh means intervals. There are intervals. Every 2 rakats, there were intervals in prayer. So this taraweeh or qiyamul layl, it is necessary that you have to read Quran in a way which is called وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا. When you read it or when you listen to it, you should be able to understand, and you should have time to understand Quran. But normally it is a practice that in our most of the taraweeh prayers, our focus is to complete 20 rakah, or our focus is to fast, finish it very fast. And it is an attraction that in many mosques, if it is taraweeh is finishing within half an hour, it is a matter of attraction for a lot of people go to that particular mosque, because within half an hour you can finish everything. That should not be the case. Quran says, إِنَّ نَاشِئَةَ اللَّيْلِ هِيَ أَشَدُّ وَطْأً وَأَقْوَمُ قِيلًا. Verily, getting up in the late night or praying the tahajjud prayer or qiyamul layl, it is good for self-purification and to read Quran. So in the month of Ramadan, when you pray taraweeh, it should be in such a way that you should have enough time to ponder over or listen to it Quran with intervals, and to ponder over what you are reading. And that kind of taraweeh, we have to practice it in our life, and that kind of recitation of Quran, we have to practice it in our life. And also, In reading, it is necessary that when you read it with soothing voice, it is very impressive. There are a lot of beautiful reciters in this world, and you can see that how impressive it is. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he used to listen from Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala. One day when he was listening from Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala, and he was reciting Quran to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he reached to a particular verse which says, فَكَيْفَ إِذَا جِئْنَا مِنْ كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ بِشَهِيدٍ وَجِئْنَا بِكَ عَلَىٰ هَٰؤُلَاءِ شَهِيدًا. It explains the scenario of Day of Judgment, that when witnesses are brought forth from every community, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam will be produced as a witness in front of all of them, that whether you have conveyed this message or not. And when he was reciting that, see, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was not only listening to the beautiful voice, but he was grasping the deeper meaning and insight in the message of Quran. And he was so impressed by that, that he started weeping and tears started rolling in his cheeks, and he said, stop. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam started thinking about the responsibility of Quran. That's why in hadith Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Watlul Quran wabku, means read Quran and weep, read Quran and ponder over, read Quran and think, read Quran and comprehend about the responsibility. And this kind of reading is necessary, and regular reading is necessary. In the responsibility of reading, it is necessary that we have to read it regularly, we have to read it with tajweed, and we have to read it in a beautiful way. And also it is a responsibility in reading that we have tried to memorize it. Memorizing Quran is also another mu'jiza, miracle of Quran. It is such a big, voluminous book which can be memorized with its entirety. No other book in this world can be memorized. No other constitutions of any other country, or no other books like big religious epics, it cannot be memorized. There is no such example that people are memorizing the religious scriptures. But with Quran, from the day one, even today, there are thousands of people who are called Huffaz, who commit the Quran to their memory with its entirety. And this can be possible only with Quran. And this is the mu'jiza of Quran, that it can be memorized easily. And memorization courses are there for children. And it is necessary that Muslims should continue the practice of developing Huffaz, the people who memorize Quran in their community. And it is necessary that we have to think about our own children, our own family members, that at least one of them, at least some of them should memorize Quran, and this practice should continue. In many countries I can see that, especially subcontinent, only poor people, they send their children to the courses to memorize Quran. It is not the responsibility of only poor people. It should be responsibility. Every Muslim should feel that at least someone from my family should memorize Quran, and these are some of the responsibilities with regard to reading. Now let me come to the second responsibility, a third responsibility, that we should understand Quran. It is responsibility. Quran is sent in Arabic language. Why? Because its first addressees are Arabs. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala has sent message to different communities in different languages. First addressees. Who are the first addressees? He sent the message to the first addressees in their language. What is the purpose? Purpose is to make them understand. If the first addressees are not understanding the real message of it, then it cannot be sent. The message cannot be disseminated to the rest of the world. That's why Quran has been sent in Arabic language, because its first addressees are Arabs. And today you can see that 80% of Muslims are non-Arabs and only 20% of Muslims are Arabs. It is necessary in this age particularly, when 80% of Muslims are non-Arabs, it is necessary that we should try to learn Arabic language to the extent that we can understand Quran, or at least take benefit from the tafaseer, from the interpretations and the translations. There are thousands of translations in different languages. We should take benefit from out of it, benefit from these books of translations. If you go to our home and check our libraries, lot of us having lot of books of engineering in our library, lot of books of management in our library, lot of books of other subject, accountancy and so many other things. But do you have tafaseer in our own languages where we can understand that language? Do you have it in our library? If you don't have it, something big mistake you are making. This is, you rectify this mistake by tafaseer. Try to understand Quran. There are two dimensions of understanding. One is tadhakkur. Quran says, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّكِرِ. We have made Quran very simple for you to understand. Is there anyone who can understand? There are so many things in Quran which is very simple to understand. For example, when Quran says, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Be generous towards parents. Do good towards parents. This need not have to be a philosopher to understand this. One need not have to be a university graduate to understand this. This is a simple saying that you do good or be generous towards your parents. And wazinu bil qistasil mustaqim, when Quran says that when you weigh in a right scale, that means do not practice malpractice in business. Your business should be with honesty. And this is the teachings of Quran. Whenever you make transactions with anybody, and that transaction should be based on honesty, and you should be an honest businessman, and that is what is the message of Quran. This is very simple to understand for anyone. So it is responsibility that when we read Quran, we try to understand the basic and important message of Quran. Anyone can understand it in Arabic or if you read the translations. There is another level of understanding which is called tadabbur, which is deeper comprehension about Quran. Quran says, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. Why you are not comprehending about Quran? Whether there is locks in your heart has been locked. Why you are not opening your heart? Why you are not opening your mind? Why you are not thinking and comprehending about Quran? Why you are not learning the tafasir of Quran? It is necessary that everybody cannot comprehend about Quran. But it is easy for everyone to go back and refer to the tafasir. There are deeper meanings in Quran. There is a deeper message for your life. There is a good opportunity for you to understand more and more about every aspect of your life. So it should become a practice for us that we have to read and understand Quran with meaning, and we have to read and comprehend about Quran. And that is what is necessary. And also we have to teach Quran to our children. We take much time for different kinds of training we give to our children. But we are not giving enough time for their development in Islamic studies and to teach them Quran and its meaning. So it should become a practice in our life that we should spend enough time in understanding and comprehending about Quran. This is the third responsibility. Let me go to the fourth responsibility, that we should follow Quran. Quran is not only to understand and not only to read and not only to believe in and not only to respect it. The main message, the purpose of sending Quran is hudal linnas. It is a guidance to human being. If you are not guided by Quran, then your reading is waste of time. Lot of people may have lot of knowledge about Quran, and if they have not attained hidayah, then the reading of Quran is waste of time. I know a person who visited Kuwait who translated Quran into Finnish language from Finland. He came from Finland and he translated Quran into Finnish language, and he is a Christian. He knows Arabic, he knows Finnish language, he understands Quran, and he has translated it beautifully. He cannot make a malpractice in translation because Muslims may definitely object it. He is a scholar of Quran. But what is the use of being a scholar of Quran when he has not attained hidayah? So what is basic requisite of Quran is to follow it and to attain hidayah from it. And it is basically a book of guidance, not only a book of reading, but it is a book of guidance for you. And also it is a constitution for your life. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمُ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. Quran says in three different ways that if you are not deciding or decreeing everything, every aspect of your life, in every aspect of your life, according to the revelation given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you are transgressors, you are oppressors, and you are unbelievers. If you are not decreeing all aspects of your life according to the teachings of Quran, then you are not a real Muslim. So it is necessary that we have to reform and apply in every aspect of our life Quranic teachings. When you make business, see what are the do's and do nots according to Quran. It is a user manual for your entire life. How you have to lead life, Quran gives you message. And entire life should be guided by the message of Quran. Every our individual life, our family life, our transactions, our social life, there are guidance in every aspect of life. But unfortunately, we take only some aspect of life, some aspect of teachings of Quran. For example, when Quran says, Kutiba alaykum siyam, fasting is prescribed to you, we take it, we fast in the month of Ramadan. But if you go back to the Surah Al-Baqarah, the same in Surah Al-Baqarah, there are two other things mentioned with the same word kutiba, prescribed. Kutiba alaykum idha hadara ahadukum al-maut. And it is prescribed that when some of you reach the time of death, then it is prescribed that you have to illustrate how your wealth should be distributed. And there are civil laws mentioned in this Quran. And it is also prescribed, it is mentioned that it is prescribed for you. And Qutiba alaykum al-qisas. Again, there is mention about a criminal law that it is also prescribed for you. There are so many kinds of regulations which is prescribed for you. And if you take only some aspect of Quran, some regulations of Quran, and we are not doing anything with the rest of the regulation, that means we are not fulfilling the entire responsibility we have towards Quran. And this is the fourth responsibility, that we have to follow Quran in every aspect of our life, and we have to become a living example of Quran. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was a living example of Quran, and he established the society based on Quranic teachings. And the last but not least is the responsibility of conveying the message of Quran. It is necessary for Muslims that they have to convey the message of Quran. خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the best among you is the one who learns Quran himself and teaches others. And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says, بَلِّغْ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ. O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you convey what has been revealed to you. وَإِلَّنْ تَفْأَلْ فَمَا بَلَّغْتَ رِسَالَتَهُ. And if you are not conveying, you are not fulfilling the responsibility of prophethood. Wallahu ya'simuka minan nas, and Allah will protect you from evils of people. And today we can see that there are a lot of evil of people. Muslims are blamed as terrorists. There is a big propaganda that Islam teaches terrorism. There are a lot of misunderstanding in this world. And how you will be protected from this evil? Only by conveying, by clarifying, by communicating. And it is our responsibility that you have to communicate the message of Quran to the people who have lot of misunderstanding. And this is the fifth responsibility. We have to fulfill all these five responsibilities, and we have to rejuvenate and inculcate these responsibilities. Month of Ramadan is coming to make this pledge and to strengthen our relationship and to rejuvenate our relationship with Quran. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala give us guidance and blessings to rejuvenate and strengthen our relationship with Quran. Barakallah, barakallahu lana wa lakum, wa nafani wa iyyakum bi ayatihi wa dhikril hakim. Innahu ta'ala jawadun karimun malikun barur raufur rahim wa rabbun halim. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. الصلاة والسلام على رسوله الأمين وعلى آله وأصحابه الطاهرين أما بعد فقال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتاب الله العظيم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد بعدد من صلى وصام اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد بعدد من قعد وقام اللهم صل على جميع الانبياء والمرسلين وعلى سائر الصحابه والتابعين وخلفاء الراشدين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم اجمعين اللهم ايد الاسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وجعلنا منهم اللهم اخذل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا منهم اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون واذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر وأقم الصلاة